If you compare that with the X-ray finding and MRI, we can see this finger here, where there is a skin reaction, the reddish skin lesions compatible with psoriatic disease. We see also nail changes. And this very same finger is enlarged here in this X-ray. We can see there is this ill-defined margin of the bone. So the regular bone has a sharp contour. In this inflamed joint, we see there is irregular contour of the bone on both sides. And this is called periosteal reactions or spicule. And we see also the destruction of the bone due to the synovitis, which is the erosion that we see on the marginal position. So we have the this combination of proliferation and destruction, which is very typical for psoriatic arthritis. If you compare it with the MRI, we can see that indeed we see the entesial inflammation in this high resolution image. So we see the joint capsule over here. So the joint capsule is attaching to the bone. And here, this side, there's only few inflammation. So there's only less gadolinium enhancement. But on this side, we have a lot of inflammation. So we see this very intense inflammation at the periosteum and also at the attachment of the capsule. And this can lead to a full osteitis. So you see this entire bone is inflamed. So psoriatic arthritis is defined as an arthritis, but it's in fact a disease that affects entire bones. So it's really much more aggressive to the bones and joints compared to rheumatoid arthritis.